Hi everybody and welcome back to the Naio Nails channel. I'm Kirsty Meekin and I am joined today by Matt Fong, who is a comedian.
Hi, thanks for having me again.
You may have seen him in other videos. We thought it'd be pretty cool to do a guy's nails. Today we're going to do something a little bit silly. We're going to do a really long nail. We are going to join three sculpting forms together and do a really long nail. Three forms. I'm going to layer them. So, when you are making a form super, super long, you still want to put your tab on the back. And what we're going to do with this is you're still going to take your tab out. It that way, and you can either go on top or underneath. To be honest with you, it really doesn't matter as long as you keep this hole here free. So you've got to make sure it's not interfering with that hole, but you still want it to run straight. So it is easier to place them on this way than that way, because you can't quite see what you're doing unless you want to flip them over and do it like this, but then you still can't see the lines on the form to know it's running straight. So I find it easy to do it this way, so I can see that these lines are all running straight through. If they don't, you'll have a wonky nail. Popping that line down level with that. And you can see this line is matching as well. Now we could keep going. We're just going to keep these at three. And then you still need to roll your form. So I'm rolling it between my hands, not just my thumbs. I'm going to close this end and then again we're going to roll and we can go a little bit tighter. Once you've got a bit of a curve, you can go a bit tighter with your thumbs. I'm going to close from the end first because I want to check the angle. Because it's so long, I need to open the back a little bit. So we're opening this part here. Right, so I need to just only twist a little bit that way because your finger kind of twists in. Mine do as well. You see how they kind of twist in a bit. So that is perfect position. I'm kind of scared.
You're scared?
So we're going to do a stiletto nail.
Excellent.
So I'm going to dehydrate the nail.
Does that help it become sticky for the acrylic or...?
No, this one does. Oh my God, have you been watching my videos?
Just one or two.
Yeah. So primer kind of acts as a double-sided sticky tape, but it also puts the pH to a similar pH as the acrylic, so I'm told. I'm going to do this in natural beige. I'm going to make a connection between the nail and the form. You notice I haven't bled that bead out. I want it to be quite thin. I want it to be thin so it'll still pinch and bend once it's set. This is a challenge for me, this is. Right, so we're going to chase this down the length of the nail. So I'm tipping the finger down. Going all the way to the end of that form.
Wow.
I'm going to build this up now.
So you've got the foundations down?
Yeah. Foundations are down, and now the house needs building.
Weirdly, I thought you were going to start from the tip.
I know. Well, this is what I was thinking, but it was just going to make it far too difficult for myself to do that. Make sure you blend each bead together so you have no obvious join. Oh my god, it looks like a Harry Potter wand. So I'm just going to pinch this part of the nail for now. Just going to check. I can pinch this bit out. So I'm kind of working on a bit and pinching. I do think we should make it into a wand. I feel like I'm creating a mountain.
Yeah, it's definitely sculpture, isn't it? Limited amount of time between application and setting.
That back again. Right, let's sort out this now and give it some better definition. It's a bit lumpy bumpy, so I need to smooth it out by adding more product. Right, now back to the apex. Tipping the finger down.
Definitely feels heavier.
Does it?
There's a definite
weight
on it. Yeah. Just
put a few pounds on.
Yeah.
So the longer the nail, the bigger the apex will be as well. So it's got quite a hefty apex going on. I can just see some dips that I need to adjust. God, check down the barrel. That's some barrel, that is. The longer it is, it's so much more difficult to get it smooth as well. Because when I look down the barrel, I can see imperfections. But I think they are imperfections I'm going to have to file a tad bit more here. Doing it quite wet because I want it to lay quite thin and even. That is a long nail. I just need this to set up a little bit more.
And it's free. Whoa. That's a
bit weird, that.
Yeah, yeah.
A little bit weird. I don't know if the file's long enough. Right, I'm going to just snip some of these little tiny pieces off because they're very thin. So it won't do anything to the nail. Oh my god! So support the nail whilst doing the filing. I'm going to do my normal filing routine. I'm going to do the sidewalls first. Right, I need to get this part done really neat. So where it comes out of that natural nail. I need to get...
Oh.
I just can't stop laughing. I just keep looking at it thinking, what the hell is this? What is that? Just look at it. Oh my god. Hey, I'd have a field day painting some designs on it though, wouldn't I? Right, I think what I'm going to do is break it down. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to file this part first and get this nice. Because it's kind of overwhelming me. Right, so I'm sort of happy with the end part here. Now we need to move up. So you guys are learning as I'm learning, because I've not done that one this long. I'm actually shocked that I've never done one this long.
You know the...
Oh, hold on. I'm a liar. I've done ones longer than this. I did like a female version of Edward Scissorhands, but the nails that were on had like blades coming out of them, so yeah. I made the blades
separately.
Yeah, so it wasn't like made. I've never made one this long on somebody's actual finger. So I think that's why it's quite weird to file and to do. But yeah. I like it.
All the powder that's coming off all the acrylic, is that bad for you if you breathe it in, or?
It is, yeah, yeah.
should we have, because there's a lot coming off now. I'd imagine on a nail this size, not much is going to hurt you.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, I think my damage is done. I've had 20 years of dust inhalation, and I think the lungs will be knackered by now. Maybe I should be wearing a dust mask. But it is only one nail. I think if I was doing all 10, I would be crying by now. but I do think that I would have wore a dust mask. I didn't anticipate the amount of dust, really. Maybe I should have. Because the amount of acrylic that's actually in this one nail could probably do, you know, 2-3 sets. So, yeah. Nice. It's looking good. Right, let's look at this side profile. I'm going to wipe over with pure acetone. Quite a lot. And smooth it out. The acetone will slightly melt the top layer and make it nice and smooth. And then we're going to put the Urban Graffiti top coat on, which will make it really smooth so we can apply the metallic. So because it's so long, I'm going to start here and get the bulk of it on.
And this is the Urban Graffiti, isn't it?
Urban Graffiti. Right, so I'm working from the tip to the top now. I'm going to get this cuticle area nice and neat. And I'm going to go all the way down. Okay, pop it into the lamp. I'm going to use all these metallics. We will link them
this
below.
This one. All of them.
So you've got one of them pointy things that when you're doing like...
When I'm doing a presentation.
Yeah. I'm going to have a bit of... like that there. And we'll have a bit of this. And then we'll have...
It's like a unicorn horn.
Oh, don't start.
Oh my god. That.
She'll now want to actually make it into a unicorn god. Horn. You just opened your mouth, Matt.
Oh my god. That would be absolutely amazing.
We do unicorn horn nails, but it's nothing this long.
Nothing this long.
No.
I think because this is just not practical.
The longest nail you ever did see. once upon a time was on your finger. I'm just making sure I've covered every little bit now. Now we need to top coat it. I'm going to start at the tip again because it's so long. Work my way up. So now I'm going to drag down, and I can also drag off any excess while I do this as well. I'm going to have to acrylic some of the big ones on, but we'll just glue the other ones on. So yeah, we definitely need some bling just to complete the look. Well, I absolutely love it now. Oh, I just need to put a bit of cuticle oil on. You shall go to the ball, Cinderella.
Yeah.
I can't believe you've let me do that to you. Oh my God, as if you've let me do that.
I'm really impressed. It looks great.
I love it. I think I'd probably wear that. I would wear that. Not for every day. And not for football.
Just for royal weddings and street fights.
Yeah. Definitely. It's like a piece of jewellery.
No, it really is.
Isn't it? So yeah, guys, I hope you've enjoyed the video. I mean, we just did some crazy stuff. Nice. Just fancied doing a really long nail on a guy. Just to be different, because we like to be a bit different on this channel. So thank you very much, Matt, again, for coming.
Thanks for having me. It's been a blast, as always.
Yeah. Enjoy your nail.
I will do.
Have fun.
I'm going to go try and get hammered now. I've had enough with nails, so let's do that.
All the products that I've used today will be listed below as always. And don't forget to check us out on our social media. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.